Boxing superstar Ryan Garcia was live on Twitter today talking to fans, and one fan asked him, did Tank beat him or did he lose to Tank? Jake Paul's best friend was on there too, and he talked to him about Ryan told the guy, I can't wait to see your face when Mike Tyson knocks out Jake Paul. And he said that if Jake Paul wins, that it was prearranged. That's what Ryan said. He said that's what he believes. Ryan was asked about a fight with Lomachenko. He said he would have loved that. So you have to hear his answers about Gervonta Davis, about Lomachenko, and of course about fighting Sean O'Malley. Sean O'Malley is decent. He's good in MMA, but boxing is a whole other sport, and he should not try to get into the sport of boxing. And Ryan says he's willing to fight him in the UFC in a cage. So check it out, guys. Here you have Ryan Garcia talking about some hot topics, including Mike Tyson, Jake Paul, Gervonta Davis rematch, Lomachenko fight, and Sean O'Malley fight. Check it out.
You can speak.
I can speak?
Yeah, of course, bro.
All right, Ryan, I'm going to ask you, like, a weird question, but, like, you got to, like, listen to it, you feel me? Okay. All right. Did you lose against Tank, or did, like, Tank win?
Did I lose against Tank, or did Tank win? I think those both are true. It's a trick question.
Nah, you got to, like, listen to it. Like,
okay. All right, go.
I already said it.
Okay, did I lose against Tank, or did Tank win?
You know what? You gotta like think.
Dumbest question I've ever heard in my life,
bro. Somebody help me here, bro.
Just think, bro. You're not thinking, bro.
Nigga, bro, I was trying to think, bro. You got me.
Let him answer it, nigga. He gets the question.
Take your time, bro.
I am. It's like a riddle.
Well, I would say
Tank won because you don't lose. That's a good mentality.
All right, hop off his meat, bro.
Stay winning. Oh my God. I'm just saying, like, if that's a fucking question, like, you would pick that option, surely. You don't want to call yourself a loser.
But Ryan beats him at 140, you know?
Yes, for sure. So if that's the question you're saying, yes, Tank won because he won in negotiations.
Come on, bro.
Yeah.
All right, I'm being real, bro. Look at it. At the end of the day, everything I said is facts. If it wasn't true, it wouldn't be so. Look, am I man enough to say I signed the contract? Of course. But I'm also going to be man enough to say that was some stuff that I say 99% of boxers won't take. So, and I didn't need to take those clauses in my position. I had money. I had everything. What I didn't have was the trust of the people that I was going to go in there and get in the ring amidst all the things that they put against me. Now, if you guys could get in the ring dehydrated and almost on the verge of basically dying, then you could speak on how I felt in the ring. At the end of the day, I know what I was up against. I did it for boxing. I sacrificed my well-being so the sport could propel. And you see, after that, Errol Spence, Crawford got in the ring, and many other people started getting in the ring and fighting each other. So say what you want. I went and changed the sport on how I felt it needed to be changed. But now boxing, I'm good.
Boxing is about politics. That's what they got to understand. A lot of people don't understand the business aspect of boxing. Before you can actually critique somebody for losing, you do have to look into the contracts that they sign. If you dehydrated, if you ever been dehydrated before, you're weak as hell. Look at Errol Spence. Errol Spence is dehydrated.
Drink Prime.
If all right, I challenge anybody to be dehydrated and just try to play some basketball. Just try to play some basketball, let alone being in the ring in front of millions of people with pressure all around you. Like, come on. You can't even study for your test dehydrated. Don't even get on me about nothing.
Wait, Ryan, I don't mean to interrupt. Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt, but like, if we can, low key, if we get one more co-host, we can get one like extra slot in.
Okay. I'll do it.
Yeah, just get.
I got you.
Yeah, get.
Kenny got you. Yeah, type shit.
I got you, bro.
I give it to Wayne. Honestly, he's your biggest fan. It's number one.
Supporter. Wayne is Jake Paul's biggest fan. Hey, Wayne, can you speak?
Yeah, what's up? What's up, bro?
What's up, bro? Tell me about Jake Paul. Come on, bro.
All right, let me tell you a little about Jake Paul. You know, that's my nigga, you know. I love
Jake. I already know, bro.
With you too. You know, look, like, I had you beating the shit out of Tank. You know, fortunately, you know, you were injured. You know, shit happens, you know. You're going to get him at 140.
Right. I mean, hasn't the sport suffered enough? Think about it. You know, as many times as people complain that nobody's fighting anybody, look at me. I'm fighting everybody, and everybody's still complaining. So I'm just showing people that, you know, when you give them what they want, it's always a problem. But look, my whole thing is, I came into the sport to bring back the feeling I would get when I would watch a Floyd Mayweather fight, Oscar De La Hoya fight, or a fight that just made you excited before that bell rang. And I didn't know how that was going to go down, but I knew that if I just listen to the people and just understand and give them what they want, you know, no matter what, you know, I'm doing things for me. I remember a story when my mom, you know, I was in the amateurs. My mom goes, why don't you just go in the lower weight class to avoid X, Y, and Z? I said, why would I do that? I want to fight the best. And I stayed in the toughest weight class, and I became a national champion in that weight class. So that just carried on to where I'm at now.
Yeah, you're a legend, brother. Keep working, man.
Everybody's talking too loud in the background. Okay, Amber, you could talk.
I don't have my hand up, but I'll ask you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you did.
No, it's fine. I'll ask you a question. Okay. So you said that you want to fight in MMA, but you put out a tweet yesterday saying that MMA fighters shouldn't cross over into boxing. Yes. What makes you think that you can cross over into MMA?
Well, because it's very unfair for MMA fighters to come to boxing, as we've proven it over and over again. But I think that there's a chance if somebody took it serious, right? A little example is Clarissa Shields. She's kind of making noise in I think it's PFL MMA. But for me, I think because of my determination and my natural ability to catch on to things, and people don't know I've been wrestling for a long time, for years now, and I'm doing really well. So if I put my mind to it, I'm talking about, look at 3 months of rigorous training, I can't even say that word, but you know what I'm trying to mean. And if I dedicate myself nonstop to MMA, I think I could pull it off. Now, look at, people call that crazy. They call Deion Sanders crazy when he went from football to baseball. So maybe I could do it. Why not?
He thinks it's just like some form of like healthy delusion, like your mindset, your mentality would help you get there rather than anything else.
It's only delusion if I can't, you know, if I don't do it, you know, it's like how could it be delusion if I really pull it off? You know what I mean? Like, I guess you could say healthy delusion, if you want to call me delusion.
Just in the sense of like delusion, like in terms of healthy delusion in terms of like.
There's been boxers who have Holly Holm was at a boxer and she became the world champion in the UFC.
Well, there you go. So it's not far fetched. I think people probably because they, I don't know, maybe it's
striking. Still... what's up, Ryan? I'm back. What Ryan's saying is the striking is different in boxing and MMA. Like when Floyd got in the ring with Conor McGregor, it's a big difference from when McGregor was hitting Floyd and Floyd was hitting McGregor. Like, we strictly in boxing just work on the striking, the punches. Yes, so yes. when Ryan throw a hook, it's different from when somebody from MMA throw a hook. You know what I'm saying? That's the smaller way to put it.
And because, look at, they have to worry about, let's say, look at, they have to worry about kicks, et cetera, takedowns, so they can't deliver the type of punches we can. We're fully confident you ain't going to kick me. You know what I mean? So we could transfer all of our energy into that punch. Yeah, I will say Sean O'Malley's pretty good at striking, but so was Conor McGregor. And then when he got in the ring, they weren't too powerful.
Yeah, right. Think about this. If you can dodge, if we're slipping punches, right? If you could dodge a punch, you could see a kick coming a mile away.
That's what I'm trying to tell people. I've had people try to kick me before. All they do is pick my hand up, block. Okay, they say calf kicks. Okay, well, let me learn how to check. They can't be that hard. I mean, it could be hard, but people that have trained in MMA all the whole time still can't check a kick all the time. Sometimes you got to just take that bitch. I'm sorry, excuse my language. Sometimes you got to take it. And it is what it is. My bad, guys. But it's hilarious. You know, can I learn how to check a kick? Yes. Can I learn how to sprawl? I already know how to do that. Can I learn how to defend submissions? I'm pretty sure I can. So to me, it's not far-fetched.
But the punching is definitely different. Like, if you're trying to kick somebody, we can catch your kick. Once we catch your kick, you don't want to feel one of these straight rights to left hooks with a boxer. And know what they're doing.
Hey, bro, with 6 ounce gloves, I don't think you want to feel. I mean,
that's what I'm saying.
I mean, or whatever, 4 ounce gloves. Yeah, we could always run that. You know, I would love to fight Loma. I mean, look, if I fought Tank, I'll fight Loma. I mean, that's not a problem for me. I would love that. I really want to know. I already know who you have for this fight, but who do you think is going to win, Jake Paul or Mike Tyson?
Oh, Jake Paul.
Oh, my God.
Hey, who you got?
I bet Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson is huge, bro. There's no way Jake Paul is taking this, bro.
Yeah, Jake Paul's not going to knock him out, but I got Jake Paul winning by, you know, split decision, you know?
Wayne, I want to see your live reaction when Jake Paul gets knocked out. I just want to, like, I need to see it, bro. Can you record yourself?
What's your hate towards him, though? What's your hate?
I don't have no hate, bro. My problem is I've let it go too long. He's making a mockery of boxing. He's stealing so much money out of these kids that really put in. And what I'll give him credit to, he is supporting a lot of fighters. I have respect for him. I've known him for years. Who do you think he went to his... Ask him whose house did he go in Victorville to see how to box. Ask him that.
You did help him, you know. Like,
no, I started him off. Who do you think took him to Canelo's gym? Me.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm the one that started his career. Little did you know. I'm the one that gave him the idea that he could do this and change and make money off it. I'm the one who did it. Why do you think I'm the one that said, "Why, dang, I don't feel like I should have done this"? But again, I'm not trying to knock no other man's hustle down. Let him do what he got to do. But one day he has to see me, Wayne, and then you got to pick who you're going to go for, and I already know who you're going to go for. But when I beat him, just say, Ryan, you're my favorite fighter. That's all I got to hear.
Hey, check this out, though. Real quick, Wayne. I want to give props to Jake Paul because I'm not going to knock him. Like, he's not... Like he's pretty good, you know, for a new person doing it 3 years. But what I'm saying is, you like Mike Tyson, bro. Like he still is a monster. Like you don't step in the ring with something like that when you're a beginner.
The only way Jake Paul wins this fight is if they have it already coordinated for him to win. That's it. That's the only way. And has that happened in the sport before? Yeah.
But what do you think about Mike Tyson's stamina at this age? If it goes past two rounds, I don't see how he wins.
Mike Tyson, I mean, he went a couple rounds with Roy. How many rounds?
That was like 8 rounds, right?
Okay, so, I mean, I think he only needs 4 to beat Jake Paul. But, you know, I don't even think he needs 4. I think if Mike hits him one good one, it's over. Just me. I've met Mike. Mike is a different breed, bro. When he steps in the room, you're like, all right, now I know why people were scared.
Fair. Ryan, what do you think of the Saudi cards? Do you like? You think it?
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.